Golf Central on YouTube, brought to you by the Chrome Soft Golf Ball from Callaway.
Hi there, I'm Todd Lewis. Proud to be sitting beside a four-time PGA Tour winner and proud Georgia Bulldog Billy Kratzer. Not too far from Athens is Congaree, where the PGA Tour is this week. It is the Palmetto Championship at Congaree. This is replacing the RBC Canadian Open that unfortunately was canceled due to COVID-19, but is expected to be back on the PGA Tour schedule next year. Wes Roach, first time he has ever led after any round on the PGA Tour, shoots a 64, highlighted by a front nine, 30, and there you see Dustin Johnson. Proud South Carolinian, number one in the world. He shoots a 65. So does Doc Redman, who attended Clemson, also in South Carolina. Chesson Hadley, he's missed 9 of 11 cuts on the PGA Tour this year, but he shoots a 65. Eric Van Rooyen, he's missed 4 consecutive cuts, but he shoots a 65 as well. Jonathan Vegas, by the way, he was involved in U.S. Open qualifying on Monday in Columbus, Ohio, that spilled over into Tuesday. He made it through, will be at Torrey Pines, but it's been an exhausting day, and how about that? Shoots a 66. Time now to hear, though, from Dustin Johnson, the world's number one player, after that impressive 65.
Yeah, I felt like I drove it really well. Even the last hole, I hit a really good drive. It went just, you know, just through the fairway, sitting in the mulch, so I kind of had to play over to the left. I just didn't know how it was going to come out. Obviously, yeah, made a really nice chip in there. I would have taken just an up and down, would have been just fine with me. But hit a really good chip, and it just got to the hole and went in. So, it definitely ended the day on a good note.
We had talked earlier in the week, you had said the putter is kind of the key club in your bag that you want to elevate to what you've been able to do, I mean, earlier this season. How would you rate your putting today?
It was okay. I mean, I hit some good putts. The greens are kind of tricky to read. I mean, even, you know, I missed one short one there on the par three, five, I guess. I think it's the par three. But, you know, I hit the putt right where I wanted to. It broke hard right, and I didn't see that in the putt. But, it's going down my lines, and, you know, my speed was pretty good today. So I'm happy with the way I rolled it. You know, obviously 6-under was a good score. But, yeah, you know, still missed quite a few short makeable putts.
You had the break since the missed cut at Kiowa. I know you were able to go on a fishing trip, kind of free your mind. What did that do for you today, and how hungry were you to get back?
Yeah, I mean, you know, like I feel like I've been playing well, just haven't been, you know, scoring very good. You know, the putting's been off, and, you know, it's just like, you know, small little mistakes that you shouldn't make. So, yeah, sometimes just taking a little bit of time away and, you know, kind of clearing the head, it definitely helps. And, you know, put in a lot of good work last week, and I felt like I'm swinging good. So if I can keep the putter rolling, you know, it's going to be a fun week.
Final question, you're getting the order of the Palmetto today. I know you're a very proud South Carolina guy. To have another PGA Tour stop here and to receive that distinction, what does it mean to you?
Yeah, it's great. Obviously, it's something that I'm very proud of. And, you know, being a South Carolina native, it's, you know, it's really cool, and it's been great to play a lot of tournaments in South Carolina this year.
It's right. This is the third PGA Tour sanctioned event in the great state of South Carolina. DJ honored by the governor after his round. He is from Columbia, attended Coastal Carolina University, and he shoots a 65, which ties his lowest opening round dating back to June of last year. And the last time he shot 65 in the Masters, we know what he did there. That was in the fall. He won, and he's also had success by shooting some good opening rounds as well, as you can see by that graphic. So it seems to me that Dustin Johnson is going to be the force that people are going to have to try to take down over the weekend. Is that what you're taking?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's like a horse race. You know, you look at that horse that gets out quick and keeps leading and never relinquishes the lead. And that's kind of, when you look at that graphic right there, that's kind of what Dustin Johnson's done when he's gotten off to that quick start, where he shoots 65 or he shoots 67. And he's that kind of player that continues the good play. We saw it last year in a five-week stretch where seemingly every week that he played, he was in the final group. And, you know, he didn't win them all, but yet he was the Masters champion. He played well at the PGA, obviously the Tour Championship. He just continued that good play. So I think when you look at Dustin Johnson, when you hear in his voice that he feels as though the layoff, the rest, did him plenty good, then that's when he becomes that dangerous player, because he did the same thing after the one round at Minnesota last year, went back to Florida, then all of a sudden came back, and it was magic.
Hey, let the world on fire in the fall. And by the way, his deficiency over the last few months has been putting. He admits that. He had 23 putts on the day. So the putter going in the right direction for Dustin Johnson, which could be scary for those, as I mentioned, in the field. Another guy who had a great putting day, that being Wes Roach. He leads this field after round number one in strokes gained putting, puts up that impressive 64. He leads heading into the second round. Here's what Wes Roach had to say after his round on Thursday.
I did everything pretty well. I drove it nice. I putted as good as I have in a while. And I made it from 104 yards on the fourth hole. So that was a nice bonus as well.
As a fan, it looked like it was an easy round. What was it actually like inside the ropes as you started making birdies and getting on a run?
Yeah, I got off to a good start. I mean, I made a nice par, nice sit up and down from the sand on one, and then made a couple birdies and then holed out there on four. It was kind of on cruise control. I hit a lot of good shots, kind of right where I was looking up until, I guess, right around 12 and 13. Got a little bit off, but, you know, relied on my short game a little bit and was able to make a few pars and then made another birdie coming in on 16, so it was a good day.
Your low round this season on the PGA Tour, you're leading the field in putting. You said it was as good a day putting as you've had in a while.
Right.
How did you put it together to have that type of flow?
I changed putters a couple weeks ago. I had 3 weeks off before this week, and it's working well. I played well with it back home, and it's nice to see the ball rolling where I'm looking, and going in the hole is a bonus.
Great plan. Thanks for the time.
Thank you.
Speaking with our George Savarikas there, a little backstory on Wes Roach. Grew up in Knoxville, Tennessee, where he still lives. He's 32 years of age, playing between the Korn Ferry Tour and the PGA Tour this season, because he has conditional status on the PGA Tour. His best finish, a tie for third at the 2019 Rocket Mortgage. And here he is leading for the very first time in his PGA Tour career. When he puts his head on a pillow tonight to go to sleep, what's going through his mind, do you think?
Well, sure, he's going to think about the round. He's going to think that, you know, hey, I'm leading after 18 holes. Unfortunately, there's 54 holes left, and you hope that he plays well. But it's always good. You talked about DJ's putting. Wes Roach finally putting well. It's always good to see when a player, they put the time, the effort, you know, the hard work into it, and then they see the results. You know, there are a lot of times on the PGA Tour, these guys will put in that time, that effort, and not see the result for 3, 4, 5 weeks down the road, or they may never see it the rest of the year. So it's good that Wes Roach went out, had the putting day that he had. It's good that DJ went out, had the putting day they had.
433rd player in the world, leading the number one player in the world by one shot, along with several others. We didn't know what to expect quickly from Congaree. Mm-hmm. What did you digest watching some of the world's greatest players take on this golf course?
Well, I think they were puzzled at times. I think the greens were difficult to read. In fact, DJ said he thought the greens were difficult to read. But tomorrow I expect better. When you look at the cut, you kind of think that it's even par right now if it maintains where it is. But I think now that they've had one competitive round under their belt, I think you're going to see better putting tomorrow, maybe lower scores.
It's a cool golf course visually to watch. If you've ever been on the property, you'll notice that as well. He is Billy Kratzer, and I am Todd Lewis. We thank you so much for watching, and we will see you once again